WSN has partnered with ARI, and we're working directly with the school district to assess the needs of the elementary schools and also the high school in determining the furniture needs for the buildings and what's best going to fit the educational delivery style of the school district.
I am Katie Heldenbrand with Architectural Resources, and I am in Brainerd today to talk to the school district about their FF&E, which is a furniture, fixtures, and equipment package. Every school has four walls, but it's what really happens inside those four walls that are important. One of the goals that we have during this furniture design process is to create consistencies throughout the different schools. So depending on what school you're in and what age level you're in, that the furniture types will be the same.
I'm Molly Rasky, and I'm the principal here at Nisswa Elementary School. We did a study to see how students were accessing the curriculum based on the furniture that we provided, and we found that students had more engagement if we provided furniture that allowed them to move. Every classroom has four seating options. We teach the students what it's like to be safe on that seating option and then what it provides for you. Students are very active, and we allow them to do that.
My name is Eric Storbakken. I'm an occupational therapist. We're largely operating in Brainerd on a desk and rows, a factory model for kids. So if a child is really working on something and they need a break, oftentimes they had to ask for permission to leave the desk. When I head into a classroom, I'll see desks all at the same height, and that's comfortable for the teacher, but it's not comfortable for the child. With our flexible seating, they can go up, get a tool from their little tool storage area, come back. They needed that little movement break to get refocused, to shift, just take a pause. We think of those opportunities that we have as adults embedded in our day, but how can we replicate that for kids in a responsible way?
We need to teach students to advocate for what they need as a learner and to think that that opportunity is going to be at every school. I'm so excited for what's to come for our kids.
We're really excited for the installation of the first wave of furniture come this fall, September 2020.